part of actually being a human is actually not interacting with a piece of metal, but interacting with each other and developing a piece of technology that facilitated that interaction was kind of the magic. That coherency of physical objects with the virtual world is, I think, that connection that you have with the eyes and the mind.
We approached Samsung and worked with them to come up with a mechanism to have the LCD panel sense in infrared. Suddenly the barriers were gone and we were able to process all this data.
We had to make an LCD that was robust enough to be in environments such as bars, restaurants, and other public spaces.
You wanted to feel good, you wanted to look good, and you wanted to see good.
Touchscreens today, they only see a very small sliver of information in the world. It's like walking around with a pair of really tiny holes in your glasses. And what PixelSense does is kind of open up, take off those goggles. PixelSense is sensors that sit along with output pixels in a display. We have this camera technology that's laid out, spread across the whole top of the LCD. We shoot infrared light through the LCD itself. And it passes the sensor pixels, so it reflects off the objects and it bounces back down. The camera pixels then send that information to the software, and the software interprets what those things look like, what they are.
That image in and of itself doesn't do anything if you don't examine it for patterns.
60 times a second, the entire image of everything that's on the surface is passed into the hardware. Every time we see something that's new, we assign it a number so that we can track it, so that, you know, when you put one finger down and you move it, it's not a new finger every frame, it's the same finger, it's just being moved. In the order of a few milliseconds, we package it up and hand it off to the PC as a list of, you know, we saw a finger at this location on the screen, it's number three and, you know, we told you about it last time, or it's number three and it's a new one, and then it's up to the application as to how it handles that.